Good morning students. In this class I'll be doing class 9 Samachir Kalvi syllabus or matriculation syllabus. This is the new chapter, third one, algebra, third chapter algebra. Previously I have completed real numbers in my previous class. Now from this class onwards I'm going to do algebra, that is the third chapter. So before going into the exercise sums, I'll be giving you an introduction about algebra. Okay, so algebra is a generalized form of arithmetic. In arithmetic, we'll be learning about addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and all other operations we'll be learning. That is arithmetic. That is, we'll be dealing only with numbers in that. In algebra, we'll be dealing with numbers and also with letters. Okay, numbers and also with the letters we will do all the operations. Okay, then first one is constants. So when we say constants, all the real numbers, or that is in general all numbers, all real numbers are called constants. Okay, then next one is variables. Variable means other than the real, variables means all the letters, that is all the alphabets are called variables. Constants are numbers and variables are alphabets, letters we'll say. Then coefficient. Coefficient means the constant, that is the number that is placed before a variable, that is called coefficient. So for example, if we take 4x, example for that coefficient is, if we take 4x, x is the variable and 4 is the constant. So this 4 that is placed before the variable is called coefficient. The number that is placed before the variable is called coefficient. So it can be a positive or negative number, -2xy. Okay, so in this, for the variable xy, -2 is the coefficient. So like that we'll define the coefficient. Then standard form. Standard form means when we are writing the terms in the algebraic expression, when we are writing the terms, if we are arranging the numbers in either in ascending order or in descending order, that one will be termed as the standard form. Okay, then degree of a given expression, the highest number, the highest value in the given expression, that is called the degree of the given polynomial. For example, if we take 3x power 4 plus x power 2 plus 5, so if we take an expression like this, the highest degree, this is an expression with three terms with one variable, that is only x variable is there. For this, the highest power is 4, so the degree of this expression is 4. So this is for a single variable. If we have different variables, that is 4xyz plus 2x squared y plus 5xyz squared. So if we have expressions like this, the degree will be adding all the powers, that will be the highest degree of that polynomial. So if we add this, the degree is 3, the power is 3 here. For this it is 2 plus 1, 3. This is also 3. For this one, 2, 3, 4. So the highest power is 4. So the degree of this expression is 4. So this is for the single variable, and this one has many variable in this expression. So that is called the degree of the expression. Then the next one is types of polynomial. So when we see about the types of polynomials, we have two categories in this. One is depends upon the number of terms. One is depends upon the number of terms, and the other one is on the degree measures. So we can classify this types of polynomials into two categories. One is number of terms. How many number of terms are there? Accordingly, names are given for that. And then depending upon the degree, I have explained you about the degree now. Depending upon the degree also, classifications are there in the types of in the polynomials. So if we have only one term, if we have only one term, that is called monomial. For example, 3x is a monomial. Then 2 by 3 y power 5, this is also a monomial. That is, only one term will be there, that is called monomial. Okay, one term. Then if we have two terms, that is called binomial. When we have two terms, that is called binomial. When we have three terms, that is called trinomial. That is called trinomial. In general, other than the monomial, we'll say that all the things as polynomials. Okay, we will say that as polynomials. So these are the types of polynomials depending upon the number of terms. Then depending upon the degree, we can classify it as linear polynomial. That is x, 4x. If we take this 4x, the power for the degree of this 4x plus 2. If we have expressions like this, the degree will be for the variable only. The degree will be for the variable only. Here for x is the variable. The degree of the variable is 1. So this is called linear polynomial. If the degree of the polynomial is 1, that is called linear polynomial. And then quadratic polynomial means the degree of the polynomial will be 2. That is 2x squared plus 3x plus 5. So here the degree of the polynomial is 2. So this is called quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. And if the degree is 3, that is called cubic polynomial. If the degree is 3, that is called cubic polynomial. That is called cubic polynomial. And if the degree is 4, that is biquadratic polynomial. But these three polynomials only we are going to learn in this chapter. So these are all very important terms before going into the exercise. Okay. Now we will start with the first exercise. Exercise 3.1. Which of the following expressions are polynomials? If not, give reason. So 6 sums are given. We have to find out whether the given expressions are polynomials. So first one is 1 by x squared plus 3x minus 4. So the condition for polynomial is the degree of the polynomial should not be a negative number, should not be a fraction. It should be a whole numbers only. They are called polynomials. So when we check the first equation, 1 by x squared is there. So when we bring this x squared to the numerator, the power will be negative power we will get. That is minus 2 we will get. All other terms we will write it as it is. Since we are having a negative power in the given expression, it is not a polynomial. It is not a polynomial. Since we are having the negative value as the power, as the degree. The degree cannot be a negative value or a fraction. So the degree is negative here. So it is not a polynomial. So if they are asking us to write the reason for that, degree is negative. Degree is negative. Okay, this is the first sum. Then second one is x squared into x minus 1. So first we will simplify this. So x squared into x is x cubed minus x squared into 1 is x squared. So here the degree is the power of the terms that is given. The power of the expression, all are positive powers only. So it is a polynomial. It is a polynomial. Since the highest power is, highest degree is 3, it is a cubic polynomial. But that is not mentioned here. They are not asking us to classify it. So we will write it as a polynomial. Then third one is 1 by x into x plus 5. So this one also we'll simplify. So 1 by x into x plus 1 by x into 5. So we will get this x will get cancelled. So 1 plus 5 by x. So this x when we are bringing it to the numerator, it is 5x, 5 into x power minus 1. So we are having the degree is negative. Okay. Since the degree is negative, it is not a polynomial. Okay. Then fourth one is 1 by x power minus 2 plus 1 by x power minus 1 plus 7. When we simplify this, this x power minus 2 in the denominator, when we are bringing it to the numerator, it will become x power 2. That is positive power we will get. X power 2 plus x power 1 plus 7. So, it is a polynomial. Okay. Then, fifth one is root 5x squared plus root 3x plus root 2. Root 5x squared plus root 3x plus root 2. So, we have to check the degree only in the variable. Okay. So, here root 5 is there. So, this is the constant. So, in constant, it can be a fraction or it can be a decimal number. Any number it can be. Okay. So, only we have to check whether it is a polynomial or not, we need to check only the variables, only the degree of the variables we need to check. Okay, so this is x power 2, positive power only, this is x power 1. Okay, so it is a polynomial, understood? So different varieties are there, different categories are there, so everything we need to check. So it is a polynomial. So for the variable, the power is only a positive power, it is a polynomial. Then the sixth one is m squared minus cube root of m plus 7m minus 10. Okay, so here m squared minus cube root of m, we can write it as m power 1 by 3. That is the degree we are getting it as a fraction, plus 7m minus 10. Since the degree we are having it as a fraction, it is not a polynomial. Degree has fractional number. Therefore, it is not a polynomial. Understood? So here we are asked to check whether the given expressions are polynomials. So we have checked it. If it is not a polynomial, we are asked to give the reason. So the reason also we have given. Okay, understood? So with this, I am completing today's class. Whatever doubts you have, you message me in the comment box. Thank you.